I know in spring training you said you wanted to work on your defense. The start of the season has been absolutely stellar. How much pride does that give you, knowing how hard you work and seeing the results so early?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of pride. You know, I try to focus on some things to get better at, and you know, when you put that time and effort into it, you want to see some results. And so, you know, it's been really great to have, you know, some early success here, you know, with the defense. And, you know, I think just trusting what we're doing, you know, a little bit more, and just trusting your reads even a little bit more. And so it's been great, you know, to have a little bit of early success and help the team out. But, you know, still a long season, a long way to go, but we'll keep trying to get better each and every day.
You and I also spoke the fact that you're the longest tenured player in the National League.
Yeah.
But with that, you've seen a lot of changeover in that organization. And one thing under Buck I've noticed is that no matter what the adversity is, you guys seem to just this next man up.
Yeah.
You know, the West Coast trip.
Yeah.
Max goes out, the weird circumstances.
Yeah.
Jimmy Acabonis comes in, picks you guys up.
Yeah.
Pitches you down to really one-fifth of what you thought your starting rotation is. What is that, the group of players, or is it also from Buck on down?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a combination. I think Buck starts with him and not making excuses for, you know, the hardships that we come upon. He just says, hey, pressure is a privilege and let's accept it. And, you know, the next guy up has to go out and do his best. And he's not asking you to do anything, you know, ridiculous. He's just asking for you to give it your best effort each and every day. And so, you know, that's kind of the mantra that this team has accepted, is that, you know, it's the next guy up and just go give it the best effort that you've got. And that's all we want from you. And so then the guys around this team, you know, that's what they've tried to do and expect from themselves. And then other guys see that and expect that from themselves, and becomes contagious on the team. And so I think that's just what this team is trying to do, is just, you know, go give it our best effort each and every day. And that starts from the top with Buck. And I think he's been a great addition, you know, to this team, and really important for the success that we've had.
I know that you love this game and you want to give back. You're always signing autographs, us, the media, and the fans. The other day, ESPN, you're mic'd up. What was that like? You know, having to talk in the middle of a game, all that stuff's going on.
Yeah, you know, it's different. I was a little bit interested of how, you know, how it would all work out, and keeping my focus on the game, but also, you know, answering questions. But it worked out really well, and, you know, just kind of fell back into my reactions from the game, from just, you know, what I've seen over the years and how many times I've done it. Just your first step is still there, and you know, and just in the middle, or after you're done with the play, you just, you know, go on answering the questions. But it was fun, you know. I had fun with it, and glad the fans could have that experience as well, and kind of, you know, see where I'm going, what I'm doing, you know, during the game. But you know, it's a lot of fun. It was a new experience for me, and you know, hopefully there'll be more of that.
One of the things that came out during that interview was, you know, because of the way you were fishing and in your hands, which is interesting, because Ted Williams was one of the greatest fishermen aside from baseball.
Yeah.
So there is a correlation, but I've never heard that before.
Well, I was just joking around that was what, you know, people thought. Is, you know, that I was just out there ice fishing, and, you know, somebody thought, oh, you know, this guy has good hands. And so it really wasn't like that for me growing up. You know, I grew up around sports, and I had a lot of opportunity in Wyoming. It's just, yeah, like I said on the broadcast, it probably just wasn't like Southern California or Florida or Texas, where, you know, they're playing all year round and everything. But Wyoming is just like, it seems like a foreign country to a lot of people on the East Coast. And so I was just trying to have a little bit of fun with it. But I do enjoy fishing. I do enjoy it. And Big Dan does too. So does Pete. So there is some correlation with good hitters and fishing, no doubt.
Last question, you guys. The team that's been on the road the most so far this season, 14-9, 7-3 road trip. And yet, guys really aren't clicking their all cylinders.
Yeah.
How much confidence does that give you that you guys have had this start with everyone not being?
Yeah, I think it's just that you see what this team is capable of That's what this team was built for, is so that if people weren't clicking, that other guys could carry the load. And I think that's what you're seeing early on. And so I think when we do click, you know, you'll see a nice little streak happen. But that's what this team is built for, is knowing that baseball is a game that you're not going to always be on. And, you know, sometimes other guys have to carry the load for a little while. And so, you know, that's kind of how this team was built, so that we could be consistent. And I think you're just seeing that being put into action. And, you know, we're having a lot of fun with it. Guys are coming around. They're, you know, they're figuring things out in the cage. They're figuring things out on the mound. And, you know, I think at some point you will see everybody click, and it'll be really fun. But for now, you know, it's baseball. There's going to be ups and downs, and you have to try and win even through the times when, you know, guys aren't clicking on all cylinders.